Glucose spikes lead to inflammation, which then increases acne, rosacea, psoriasis, eczema, and glucose spikes also lead to glycation, which makes wrinkles happen faster and also damage the collagen in your skin. Hello, angels, and welcome to the Glucose Goddess Show. I'm Justine Chaspet, biochemist, a French biochemist, obsessed with helping you understand your body and your food and how to be in optimal health and live the life you want to live. Today, we're talking about skin. We're going to talk about glycation, inflammation. We're going to talk about acne, psoriasis, eczema. We're going to talk about wrinkles, all that good stuff. Let's get to it. Hey, my dears. So listen, when you have a skin problem, whether it's acne, psoriasis, eczema, redness, you see it. It is there. You think about it all the time. You can feel shame around it. You cannot want to go and do social activities because of it. It really takes over our life. And often what we think of first when we see something on our skin is we think of putting something else on our skin to try to block it. So maybe it's makeup, maybe it's topical treatments, maybe it's creams, etc. Now the thing is, usually if something is going on our skin and it's visible from the outside, it's because it's trying to tell you something about what's going on the inside of your body. I know this can sound a bit counterintuitive, but your skin is like the mirror for the inside health of your body. And in particular today, I want to cover two reasons that your skin may be acting out because of glucose spikes. So for a little recap on what glucose spikes are, have a look at my other episode when I do the big deep dive on glucose spikes. But right now, I want to talk about two of the consequences of glucose spikes and how they may be affecting your skin and how avoiding spikes can help you reduce those symptoms on your skin. First things first, the first consequence of glucose spikes is inflammation. Now, inflammation is usually a normal, healthy response in the body. It helps us fight off invaders. It helps us fight off diseases and colds. But when inflammation happens for too long, which is the case when we have lots of glucose spikes that are triggering inflammation, this can lead to a lot of inflammatory-based diseases. And the ones that are related to skin that are inflammatory-based are pretty much everything. So acne, psoriasis, eczema, rosacea, those are all inflammatory-based diseases. That means that the more inflammation there is in your body, the worse those conditions are going to get. Very simply put, if you want to reduce how much of these skin conditions you're having, acne, psoriasis, rosacea, eczema, it's very important to reduce inflammation. That is the underlying cornerstone of it all. And by reducing your glucose spikes, that's going to be a very effective way of getting that inflammation down. If you're not sure where to start in terms of reducing glucose spikes, I have a free one-pager in the description of this episode with my 10 glucose hacks. So these skin conditions, when you see flare-ups, when you see redness, when you see the acne, the psoriasis, the eczema, the rosacea, they are indicating that there's inflammation in your body. And often we don't realize that we're causing this inflammation with the way that we're eating, notably because we're creating lots of glucose spikes in our body by eating a lot of starches and sugars without clothes on them, or maybe in the wrong order at the wrong time, etc. So have a look at my hacks. That's going to help you really understand how and when to eat carbs in a way that's going to reduce inflammation. Hey, really quickly, if you can't always do my food hacks and you want to eat the carbs that you love with less impact on your glucose levels, I created a capsule just for that. It's called Anti-Spike Formula. You take two before a meal. It cuts the glucose spike of carbs by up to 40%, 100% made out of plants and tested by over 25 clinical trials. Link is in the description. Okay, back to the episode. Now, of course, glucose is not the only thing that impacts our skin. There's lifestyle, there's chemicals, there's skin routines, there's stress, etc. But it's such an easy and important place to start looking, and it can bring a lot of relief to a lot of people very quickly. And there's a study that I want to mention. It's called A Low Glycemic Load Diet Improves Symptoms in Acne Vulgaris Patients, a Randomized Control Trial. And in this long Australian study, 43 male participants were randomly given either a low glycemic, low diet, so a diet that doesn't create too many glucose spikes, or one that creates glucose spikes for 12 weeks, and their acne was monitored. The participants found that in the diet group that had smaller glucose spikes, the number of acne lesions reduced significantly more, and their insulin sensitivity improved, and they also lost body fat. So all this to say that looking at your glucose levels and making sure that they're nice and steady is going to help reduce inflammation in your body, which is going to help reduce acne and other skin conditions like psoriasis, eczema, and rosacea. It is truly the first place to start looking. And to give you even more interesting data, so in my second book, The Glucose Goddess Method, I recruited 3,000 people that followed my four most important hacks for 4 weeks, and I asked them how it was going. I sent them a bunch of questionnaires. Now, this was not a randomized control trial. There was no control group. It was not a proper scientific study. It was more like an experiment. But that being said, at the end of the 4 weeks, by adding just the four hacks, 46% of the participants who had skin issues saw improvements in their skin. Just by adding my four most important hacks, which are savory breakfast, vinegar, veggie starter, and movement. And they didn't have to change anything else in their diet. We're not talking about cutting out carbs. We're not talking about counting calories. Just by adding these four hacks like gentle giants into their lives, they were able to see on their skin how the inside of their body was getting healthier, how inflammation was reducing from the inside out. Now, let's move on to wrinkles and aging. So another consequence of glucose spikes is that glucose spikes increase glycation. And glycation is a bit like what happens to a chicken when you cook it in the oven. The chicken goes from pink to brown, so it cooks, and that's actually glycation that's happening. It's just a technical scientific term for it. Now, interestingly, from the moment that we're born, we are slowly glycating. We are slowly cooking like the chicken in the oven. And this glycation, this cooking, is also similar to aging. So from the moment we're born, we slowly glycate, we slowly age. And then when we're fully cooked, fully aged, we die. I know it sounds weird, but it's true. And we cannot stop glycation from happening. We cannot stop aging from happening. But what we can do is, depending on how we're eating, we can slow it down or speed it up. And now this glycation, this aging, it shows on your face as wrinkles. It's true. So when a molecule of collagen becomes glycated because of a lot of glucose spikes, it then breaks and is no longer as flexible as before. And this shows on your skin as wrinkles and sagging skin. So if you want to slow down the appearance of wrinkles, if you want to slow down how quickly you're getting your wrinkles, well, looking at your diet and how you're eating and looking at your glucose spikes is a really, really, really important place to look. Now, of course, again, aging is not entirely defined by just how many glucose spikes you have. It's defined by lots of other stuff, like exercise. Exercise is the most powerful thing you can do if you want to slow down aging, like reducing stress, like good sleep, like emotional connection and more. But your glucose levels also have a strong part to play in this. So if you want to slow down how many wrinkles you're getting, have a look at the free one-pager in the description of this episode with my 10 core glucose hacks. And that's a really nice, easy place to start. Now, because glycation happens everywhere in the body, it also impacts other systems. Notably, glycation will impact your hair, and your nails, and your wound repair capability. So it's not just about the wrinkles on your face, it's also about all the other stuff going on around your skin, around your hair, around your nails, around how quickly you heal from a wound on your skin. So it's super key to get this glycation down so that your collagen stays nice and flexible and robust and healthy, so that your skin stays healthy and in its prime for as long as possible. So there you have it. A little recap on how glucose spikes and skin are correlated. Glucose spikes lead to inflammation, which then increases acne, rosacea, psoriasis, eczema, and glucose spikes also lead to glycation, which makes wrinkles happen faster and also damage the collagen in your skin. So if you want your skin to be bright and shiny and healthy for as long as possible, look at your glucose spikes, guys. It's super important. Free PDF in the description of this video to start your journey. You can also check out my video with my 10 core glucose hacks if you want to get some more detail on those. And that is all we have time for today. I will see you next time. Bye.